What is Stuxnet? Stuxnet is a computer worm.
It was first reported by a security company, Virus Blockada, in June 2010 and has affected millions of computers around the world.
Immediately, upon its discovery, speculation began. Computer users and experts alike all question the origins and intent of Stuxnet. There are hundreds of computer viruses and worms that are discovered every day. So, what makes Stuxnet so significant?
Put simply, Stuxnet specifically targets Scada systems.
But what makes a worm that targets Scada systems so apocalyptic?
Scada stands for Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition, and generally refers to the computer system which controls and monitors a process.
For example, a city's power grid is often controlled and maintained by a Scada system. The system regulates how much power is produced in power plants and where all that power goes.
The Scada system is able to do this because it is connected to all aspects of the power grid. It knows current and past power usage, which helps it predict upcoming requirements. It monitors and maintains, in real time, the state of all power plants in regards to their potential output by keeping track of temperatures and pressures inside the facility.
When understanding just how integrated Scada systems are with critical infrastructure, it is easy for one to see how taking advantage of this sort of system could be devastating.
Scada systems aren't new. In fact, they've been around for quite a while. Scada systems have evolved through three generations. First, the monolithic stage.
Then, the distributed stage. And then finally, where we are currently, the network stage. The evolution of Scada systems is where the security vulnerabilities lay.
The move from proprietary technologies to more standardized and open solutions, together with the increased number of connections between Scada systems, office networks, and the internet, has made them more vulnerable to attacks.
One of the main issues regarding Scada system security is the integration of older systems with new systems. Traditionally, most Scada systems were based on a variant of Unix and used on isolated networks.
Additionally, because Scada systems were used on internal networks, outside threats were not really taken into consideration. Now, with systems being interconnected through the internet, the threat of outside attackers is far more prevalent.
Back to Stuxnet. As mentioned earlier, Stuxnet, it seems, was created specifically to target Scada systems. On the surface, Stuxnet operates like any ordinary computer worm. Initially, it infects a single PC. It is thought that Stuxnet was first introduced via a USB flash drive.
The first thing that separates Stuxnet from other worms is that it infects vulnerable systems using 4 zero-day attacks.
Zero-day attacks refer to software vulnerabilities that are new and unknown. This is the first time so many different vulnerabilities were used in one single attack.
Another factor that separates Stuxnet from other worms is that it doesn't just affect any old computer. It searches for a specific type of system. If the current system is not what it's looking for, it spreads to another computer in the network.
In the case of Stuxnet, the worm was looking for a specific application developed by Siemens that is used by many industrial facilities. Experts analyzing Stuxnet deduced that the targeted software and hardware is used to operate centrifuges, which are used to distill weapons and energy-grade nuclear material.
It is now known that Stuxnet did, in fact, infect computers in Iran. President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad admitted that a worm had indeed struck centrifuge facilities in Iran, but claimed that the problem was under control.
Seeing as how it seems Stuxnet was created to manipulate the refinement of nuclear material in Iran, the ability for nations and corporations to be able to prevent and defend against these sort of attacks is critical.
Both the public and private sector are working on addressing infrastructure vulnerabilities. The implications of an attack that targets Scada systems is almost unimaginable.
Imagine this example of a terrorist attack. A group of terrorists commit what used to be unthinkable, crashing an airplane into a high-profile commercial building in order to create chaos in the immediate area.
The terrorist attack, however, was just beginning. Along with hijacking an airplane, they also enlisted computer experts to construct a computer worm that would weaken and possibly disable the emergency service systems of the surrounding area.
Something as simple as disabling the E911 system in a densely populated area during a disaster could escalate things in a mind-boggling way.
There is much mystery surrounding Stuxnet.
Who created it?
Why did they create it?
Are there more like it, just waiting to unload their payloads?
Going forward, the designers and administrators of Scada systems must decide if the benefits of cohesion, interconnectivity, and maintainability
outweigh the costs of a highly sensitive and important system going down from a cyber attack like Stuxnet.